When you start InSight, the first thing you see is the Dug InSight launcher. By default, InSight will select the most recently used project so you can quickly go back to the same project you last worked on. If the project needs changing, click Open Project to locate the alternative project directory. When you launch Dug InSight, you need to allocate enough memory to run the application. The amount of memory to allocate is dependent on the size and complexity of the project you're working on. Remember to reserve at least 2 GB for the operating system and other applications that may be running. For example, on this machine with 16 GB of total RAM, I will allocate 12,000 MB, leaving 4 GB for the operating system and other processes. The control panel includes the main application menu bar and separate tabs for each major data type. An InSight project contains everything that has ever been imported or created in the project, and which has not been subsequently deleted. A session contains a subset of the data that you want to work with right now, along with display settings like color bar and clips, line colors, window positions, zoom levels, etc. If this is your first time starting InSight, there will not be any sessions to open yet. The import menu is used to import an external file into the database and add it to your current session. Let's select the survey tab. Within the tab, the add icon allows you to load data into the session that has already been imported into the database. Load the surveys. When I select a survey in the tab, the details panel is displayed showing information about the item, such as spacing. Double-clicking the survey will open the configure window and allow editing of the survey geometry, if required. Select the view menu and open a new map view. The 2D and 3D survey are displayed in the map view. In the survey tab, use the details panel to change the survey color. Turn on or off the green light to hide or show the survey in the map view. Let's select the volume tab. I can use the add icon to load volume data into the session that has already been imported into the database. When I select a volume in the tab, the details panel is displayed showing information about the item, such as domain and sample increment. Double-clicking the volume will open the configure window and allow editing of the class, mistype values, and optimized subvolumes. Select the view menu and open a new inline crossline view. Select the 3D volume to see the traces in the section view. If the traces are missing or appear too hot, you can adjust the amplitude range using the volume details panel in the control panel. Use Zoom to Fit and Axis Stretch to quickly fit the data to the window. Set the inline increment to 100 and QC the lines by using the wheel on your mouse to scroll through the volume. Set the crossline increment to 100 and QC the crossline by using the wheel on your mouse to scroll through the volume. Select the view menu and open a new 2D line view. Select the 2D volume to see the traces in the section view. If the traces are missing or appear too hot, you can adjust the amplitude range using the volume details panel in the control panel. Use Zoom to Fit and Axis Stretch to quickly fit the data to the window. Select specific lines from the list or use the mouse wheel to systematically scroll through all the lines. Almost everything you do is visible only to you until you save your session. This means that you can continue to experiment, even on shared data, with the safety net of simply not saving your session. When you're finished, save the session using a memorable name, such as Seismic QC. You can now exit Insight. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dug.com. And remember, have fun with Insight!